PowerStop is the industry leader in the complete brake upgrade kit, providing bolt-on upgrades to your vehicle over stock OEM components. As you are making the decision to upgrade your braking system, it's crucial to learn how pads and rotors work together to maximize braking performance. When you bed in new brake pads on a new brake rotor, the pad leaves a layer of friction material from the pad onto the rotor, creating a transfer layer that helps maximize stopping power. When installing both new pads and new rotors, there is a fresh surface to mate the initial layer of friction. When doing a pad slap, where new pads are installed on old rotors, the surface is worn out and a strong transfer layer cannot be created. This would be like comparing the difference of friction qualities between sandpaper and glass. The difference between the two friction layers can also be explained by the analogy for sticking duct tape to a table versus sticking duct tape to itself. When you stick the tape to the table, it is more easily removed, as compared to sticking two pieces of duct tape to each other. Hang on, it's not happening. All brake pads use two different types of friction to stop vehicles, abrasive friction and adherent friction. Abrasive friction is pretty simple. It works similar to sandpaper. The brake pads press against the rotor and cause friction to help slow the vehicle. Adherent friction is more complex. When fresh pads are installed and the burnish or break-in procedure is completed, a very thin layer of material from the pads is imprinted onto the face of the rotor. This continues to happen during normal driving. The reason this is important is explained in the simple terms via the tape analogy. If you stick tape to a wall, it sticks okay, but it peels off relatively easily. But if you stick a piece of tape sticky side to sticky side, it's almost impossible to separate. Adherent friction works in a similar manner to the tape analogy. The pad is adhering to the thin layer of pad material on the rotor. The making and breaking of those many small bonds causes adhesive friction and helps slow the vehicle. Semi-metallic pads tend to use more abrasive friction and less adherent friction, while ceramic pads tend to use more adherent friction and less abrasive friction. In all pads, both abrasive and adhesive friction are at work at all temperatures. But in general terms, abrasive friction occurs mainly when cold, and adherent friction wakes up when the brake pads are warm and hot. PowerStop brake pads are made with a carbon fiber ceramic formula which utilizes adherent friction. Due to this formulation, it's very important to install pads and rotors together so that when the pads are broken in, they can create an adherent bond. As the leader in complete brake upgrade kits, we believe that the best possible braking performance is achieved when brake pads and rotors are changed together, allowing for an adhesive friction layer to be created. By changing these parts in tandem, you're allowing for the carbon fiber ceramic formulation to activate to provide you with the best possible braking performance. Head to PowerStop.com and use our brake finder to match complete bolt-on brake upgrade kits to your vehicle. PowerStop, brake upgrades made easy.